Hey, yo, what is up? What is up, man? What is up? Welcome back to another vid. Today we're going to be checking out. Today we're going to be talking about one of my most favorite UFC fighters, you know, who fought today and is completely just, it's sad to see, man. It went from it's Tony time to it's over Tony, because my man, dude, Tony Ferguson is getting completely, he just got destroyed, man. Bobby Green destroyed Tony Ferguson, man, submitted him, sleeped him, put him to bed, man. And it sucks to see, because Tony Ferguson was one of the most coolest and dopest and most fucking crazy motherfucker in the UFC, man. The way that he managed to keep a full 12 win streak, that's impressive, man. And against the people that he did against, he was no slouch. He did it against some of the best at that time, man. And it just sucks to see that after that Gaethje fight, you know, he just, that's it. It's over after that Gaethje fight. And man, it sucks, because like, he was an interim champ. Tony Ferguson never became a world champion. He just earned the interim bout. But it sucks that he never became champion, man. And man, someone like him, it's fucking insane. Oh shit. And it's sad to see, you know, Tony Ferguson getting slept like that, man. It's sad to see. It almost made me a little bit sad watching him just lifeless, you know, after being such a dominant force. And then after that Gaethje fight, it just all went downhill, man. He went from a 12 win streak to being in a losing streak. He's 0-6. After he fought, since he fought Gaethje, he's been 0-6, man. Man, he's been KO'd brutally by Michael Chandler. I never thought he was gonna get brutally knocked out like that, the way he was knocked out with that fucking front kick. And it was just a beautiful fucking knockout. And it's sad to see Tony just getting dropped like that, man. He's 39, man. He's getting up there in age. He's almost 40, bro. And he just keeps on fighting, man. He shouldn't keep fighting like this, man. They should just call it, man. The UFC just need to cut Tony, bro. Or the people that work, the trainers of Tony, they need to speak to him and tell him, yo, Tony, it's time to call it, man. It's time to call it a day. You know, it's just sad to see him on a losing streak. And he's not getting better, bro. Like, you know, Tony is not getting better. He's getting older and he's just getting slower, and his reaction times, and just, he's just starting to lose, you know, what made him, you know, a cuckooing, man. And just someone like Bobby Green shouldn't have beaten Tony Ferguson, man. But he did. It just shows how much Tony Ferguson has gone downhill in terms of his, you know, UFC. And just sad, man. He's literally one of my favorite UFC fighters, man. I rock with little Tony all the time, man. I always want him to win. I always want him to get that victory every time he steps into the octagon. But lately, it's just being depressing seeing him going in there and just completely just getting dominated, and just not just going on points. He's not going on decisions, bro. He is literally getting knocked out or submitted. He's getting finished. You know, Tony Kukui, he's getting finished, dude. And it's sad to see him getting finished like that. I never thought I would see him getting finished. And I want him to really just retire, because I don't want Tony to get hurt. You know, I don't want Tony to get hurt more. Because let's face it, man, he's a fan favorite, and I think it's time for Okoku to just call it a day, man. My humble opinion, man. And I hopefully he, he decides to, call it a day. and hang up the gloves, because I would love for him to do that, because I just don't want, you know, to see Tony get really hurt, get injured badly in the head. And yeah, man, Akakuri needs to stop, man. Bobby Green destroyed him. Ben Darius beat him. Who else beat him? Gagey beat him. Michael Chandler beat him. Like, he's just been listening to it. Nate Diaz finished him. There's no, I can't believe Nate Diaz submitted him, bro. That was a fight for Tony to win. Like, Nate Diaz is not in the best, you know, he wasn't in the best timing of his career either. And the fact that Nate Diaz managed to beat Tony, bro, that would have not happened a couple of years ago. Now it's just, you know, it's sad, man. I rock with old Tony. I rock with Tony, and I just, man, I hopefully, and I do hope that Tony did save his money, because, you know, he could do other things, man. Tony could actually be, he could even be a commentator. I would love if Tony becomes a commentator or an analyst, or be, or just, you know, becomes, gets another role in the UFC, man. Like, imagine him commentating on fights. That would be nice, man. You know, him getting involved in another way, man. Because I think it's time for Tony to just call it, man. Because he's not gonna get better at this point, you know. And he deserves to, you know, not get hurt badly, and, you know, maybe put him one more fight with someone who he could easily beat, so he would just, you know, ride off into the sunset with at least one victory at the end, because I would love that. And yeah, man, hopefully Tony decides to think about his career, and yeah, man, and his life, his health, and overall his future, man. But yeah, man, thank you all for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this video of talking about Tony Akakuri Ferguson. And it's time, Tony. It's time. Comment and subscribe. Let me know what you guys think about Tony Ferguson. Do you guys think he should retire? He should call it a day now, after just being on a losing streak and just getting dominated in each fight, submitted, and all finished. And yeah, man, thank y'all for watching, and peace.